This video will be presenting on a Epitaxy growth vapor phase. This will be the video timeline, the contents and the timestamp. You can skip if you want. The first one is the mechanism. Start with PVD, physical vapor deposition, evaporation of atoms or molecules using heat sputtering evaporation discharge without their chemical changes. CVD, chemical vapor deposition, transport of volatile chemical compounds using some transport gases to the heated and near surface they are decomposed. Epitaxial growth on atomically clean and flat surface of usually monocrystallical substrate is similar. As you can see photo on the left, metal and nitrogen atoms combine to form a layer of atoms. The principle, the substrate is heated in the ultra-clean gas, for example hydrogen, nitrogen, up to so high temperature where native oxides and surface impurities are dissolved and surface of the substrate is atomically clean. Later in the quartz reactor, suitable precursors will be thermally decomposed and vaccinated heated substrate. Atoms of future epitaxial layer sit on the surface, physics absorption moving to the purple crystallographic sites where they are bounded. The epitaxial layer is created. As you can see photo on the left, it shows that it's an example of mechanical organic vapor phase excitation. The question is, how does it work? It uses ELD, atomic layer deposition, a thin film technique based on gas phase chemical process sequentially. ALD is a subclass of chemical vapor deposition. Most of its reactions use two chemicals, which is all known as precursors. Precursors react with material surface sequentially. As you can see on chemical reaction above, silicon tetrachloride is introduced with hydrogen, forming silicon and hydrochlorine gas. Silane breaks via thermal decomposition, which shows that the equation is reversible and possible to do the negative, is etching. An open tube system apparatus shown is used for gallium arsenic growth. As you can see on the above, which is the dopants, and the right side is the substrate, and then another right side is the product. Advantages of using vapor phase epitaxy is that it's control method producing a film to an atomically specified thickness. Also, the growth of different multilayer structures is straightforward. Due to equipment precision, beneficial in microelectronics and nanotechnology fields, small efficient semiconductors can be produced. Fortunately, it has its disadvantages, which is that it has high substrate purity, which is very important, and high cost will ensue. Once the layer has been made and the process is complete, there may be a requirement to remove excess precursors from the final product. Example of this method application is using aluminum gallium nitride using detectors of ultraviolet radiation and high electron mobility transistors. Photo on the right is shown. The application is using integrated circuit manufacturing combines the ability of control layer growth with high wafer throughput, as you can see photo on the right.
That's all. Thank you for tuning to the video.